The gel press reusable printing plate is quickly becoming a favorite tool in my studio. Today I pulled it out along with the 6 new colors of Dilutions paint to see what kind of fun messes I could make. Along the way, I discovered that Tyvek not only is the perfect stuff to create thin masks from, it also is a fabulous surface to print on. When I started to create in preparation for filming today's video, it was with a couple of goals in mind. The first was that I wanted to incorporate the 6 new colors of Dilutions paint, and the other was that I wanted to bring masks in and use them when I made prints. The first part is really easy. I have those 6 new colors sitting right here, and we're going to use them all. The use mask part is where things got really interesting. I knew I wanted to use Tyvek for the masks because it's super thin, but it's also practically indestructible. I mean, I can fold, spindle, and mutilate this, but I cannot tear it. So I knew that Tyvek would be a perfect surface for making masks from. But that's where things got interesting. When I started to play with this, I realized that it also was a fantastic surface to print on. Now, when you look at Tyvek, you can maybe just see that there's fibers in here, and there's a little tiny bit of patterning on here, and actually that will affect your print. It will show just the littlest, tiniest bit in there, but we'll see that as we go on. So let's talk about cutting out Tyvek. The first thing is you want to have a decent pair of scissors. I'm just going to cut a circle here. When I do the circles, I just do them freeform, and they are not definitely always circular, but that doesn't matter. This makes a big white blotch or a big blotch wherever you place it. If I do this and I cut the center out of it, then obviously I'm going to get a ring instead of a solid circle. And I decided that on pieces this size, I really did like the rings better. So that's more or less what I've gone with. Really easy to do. You can see that the Tyvek cuts just fine. Now that is not a particularly pretty circle, but you get where I'm going. Where things, again, get a little bit interesting is when you want to be a little bit more elaborate. So if you have a leaf like this, it's kind of fun if you can cut some sort of a vein out of it. Now I'm going to break one of the cardinal rules of working with the gel press plate, and that is I'm going to place something on top of it, but it's just for a minute. I'm going to talk about how I've got this arranged in a second, but it matters that it's arranged the way it is, and I don't want to have to monkey with it and fix it. So this is the OmniGrid cutting station, workstation, I forget what it's called. It has a pressing sheet on one side, and it has a self-healing mat on the other. So this is really handy. I use this a lot. All I'm going to do is use an X-Acto style blade here, and I'm going to cut out these little elements. Just nip that edge right there. Go ahead and do the same thing here. And so you can get masks that become fairly detailed if you choose to do so. It just means you have to take a minute to decide on your designs and then go ahead and cut them out. All right, so that's that. So now we have this mask. Let's get all of this back out of the way. All right, so let's talk for a second about the way that I have, and I will tell you, I'm going to interrupt myself one second. Having tweezers, I find, makes it easier to get things that are not overhanging the edge of the gel press plate. Makes it much easier to get them off. Anyway, coming back to this. What I've done is, this is the 5x7 gel press plate. I have a 6x8 piece of paper underneath it taped to my work surface, and I have this gel press plate centered right in the middle of this 6x8 piece of paper. So I have a half an inch border all the way around. When it comes time to print, whether I'm printing on Bristol paper like this or I'm printing on Tyvek, I'm going to, and I have to kind of exaggerate what I'm doing here, I'm going to stand up and over looking squarely down on this surface, and if I line the edges of this piece I'm printing on with the piece of paper that's on the surface, I'm almost guaranteed, now obviously eyeballing is eyeballing, it's not accurate measurements, but I'm almost guaranteed to have my print centered on this piece. So that's important. Let me assemble the masks, pull out a couple of colors of the Dilutions paint, and I'll come back and I'll show you how simple it is to work with masks. Got some paint, a catalyst tool, and a palette knife that I'm going to use to just put the paint on the gel press plate. One of the things that I was making the mistake of doing when I first started to work with the plates was applying way too much paint. Now it's easy enough to take it off. You just use a clean brayer and you can actually roll some of it right off. It's just better if you don't have to, because it's a step that you have to take that really, why would you want to? So all I'm going to do is go ahead and put, this is Dirty Martini. I'm going to go ahead and cover my plate with this. Get it rolled out nice and smoothly. Now you're hearing me off to the side, but you're not seeing me. I'm just rolling the excess color off of the brayer so that it's ready to go the next time. I've rolled that off onto a piece of deli paper. I'm not going to do anything fancy here. I'm just going to make some lines. The point is to show you how the masks work, not to necessarily make great art. So with that done, I have something ready to print. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just use a pen and make a mark at the top of this so I know this is going to always be oriented at the top. I'm going to stand up on my toes so that when I look down, I can see that I've got this piece of paper in my hand pretty well aligned with the one that's underneath the plate on my work surface. So I'm just going to go ahead and print this and then pull my print. And you can see that I have green with stripes. Nothing spectacular there, but it's going to get interesting, I promise. So the next thing to do is to come in with some of the masks. I'm going to just lay them here in no particular order, and again, with the surface tack of the plate, it kind of holds things in place for you, makes it nice and easy. I'm just going to arrange these, and then let's just throw in a couple of the smaller ones. What I need to do is obviously have enough masked areas on here so that when I pull the next print, you can see the pattern through the openings. So let's just arrange that there. All right, so now what I'm going to do is bring in the Calypso Teal. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put some on the surface here. I can figure out what I did with my palette knife. And I'm just going to roll right over what's on here. All right, so here comes my brayer. Now before I print, I need to remove the masks, otherwise I won't see them when I pull this print, and that'll make sense in a second. Again, just clean that brayer off, slide everything out of the way, and here come my handy-dandy tweezers. These are pretty easy to take off, the ones that overhang the edge, but the others present a little bit more of a challenge. Obviously you want to try to avoid doing what I did there, which was to make a mark with the tweezer as you remove the mask. One more. So I'm going to grab my piece of paper again. I'm going to find the dot that I made so that I can orient it. Kind of stand up tall here so I'm looking down and I can see about my alignment. Go ahead and give this a nice press. Pull this off. And you can see how magically that works. So there's a thin enough coat of the Calypso Teal on here that you can see the shadow of the stripes underneath, but where the masks were is where you can really see them very prominently. Now obviously when you do something like this, once this is dry, these make nice areas to come back in and doodle or tangle in. There's lots of different ways to use these. Interesting things can happen when you work on a not-so-clean plate. You can see the leftovers from what I did a moment ago. I brought out, this is pomegranate seed. This is another of the six new colors in the Dilutions line, and it's fantastic. It's deep, and it's rich, and it's beautiful. So what I'm going to do is put some out here on my plate, and I don't care about this. The green and the blue are dry, so I know I don't have to worry about making mud. I'm just going to roll color over there, and as I said, interestingly enough, you never know what happens when you start to roll paint over a surface that's already dried like this. So I'm going to spread this out in a nice thin layer. This might have been a smidge too much paint. So here's my chance to show you what happens. Got a lot of paint on the brayer. I'm going to roll it off on my scrap paper on the side, and then I'm going to come back, and this is going to allow me to lift some so that I have a little bit of a thinner layer. If I think that I haven't removed enough, I can do the same thing. Roll some off to the side here, so that my brayer is reasonably clean, and then I can come back and roll again on the surface of my plate. I'm actually satisfied with what's there, so I just rolled enough to go ahead and make sure my brayer is clean for the next time I want to use it. I'm going to bring in a stencil this time, and this is one of ours that's called Endless, that was designed by Margaret Applin. Now you can see that there's paint on here. There are all kinds of sprays on here. I will confess to not cleaning this at all, but that provides an opportunity for some really serendipitous things to happen. The paint is pretty much, I'm just going to pick a hair off of here. I don't even have an animal and I have animal hair. The paint is pretty much going to stay on the surface of the stencil, it's not going to lift up, but any of these sprays that are not permanent will. So I'm going to place the stencil on my plate. This is an experiment, something I was playing with earlier. All I want to do is print around what's on here. This is kind of a scrap print, so I'm not going to pay super close attention. I am going to line it up more or less. And I'm going to print through the openings of the stencils. What I want to do is get the paint out and off the plate, because that's going to give me an entirely different image to work with. All right, so I think that's pretty good. I'm just going to peek under there. Because there was a fair amount of paint on the plate, I might actually need to do this twice. I think it's all right. We'll leave it alone. So now I'm going to take this stencil off, and I'm going to print what remains. And how interesting is this? Really cool patterning. So this time, I'm going to pick up, this is a piece of the Tyvek. Now, I don't know if I'm going to want to put a second layer on this at some point, so I am going to make a mark denoting the top. I'm standing up tall on my toes, looking down, and then I'm going to go ahead and print this. All right, go ahead and pull this off. And how cool is that? Now, you don't see any of the color that was on the plate. It didn't actually print this time, which is fine. I don't really care. But when you stencil, remove from around the openings of the stencil and then take the stencil off and print what remains, I think it makes a really interesting composition like this. So, you know, there's lots of different ways to work with stencils and masks. This is just a couple of them. I have another technique that I want to show you that I think is also really interesting that's going to incorporate using two stencils. This next technique requires the use of a couple of different stencils, and you need to be kind of specific when you choose. What's important is that you have one stencil like this with fairly large openings, and this is our sunflower, and then you're going to layer on top another stencil where the design is much denser. And for that, I'm going to use, this is the Punchinello Trio number 1, and I'm going to use these quarter inch dots. I also want to show you the last two colors of the six new dilutions paint. I have Cherry Pie and Tangerine Dream. So let me get them out. I'm going to let them mix right on the plate. All right, that looks pretty good. So let's just clean this off. Slide the paint out of the way. And let me brayer that on. The nice thing about working with this, and I've got too much paint, so I'm going to brayer some of it off. The nice thing about working with the gel press plate is that you can do lots of different things with color. You can go ahead and mix the way that I'm doing here. You can use single colors. You can spend some time putting gradations of color on the diagonal or horizontally or vertically. Lots of different ways to make this super interesting. All right, so let me just brayer off. Now what I'm going to do, and I'm actually going to use paper towel for this. You don't have to. You can use just some scratch paper, but this first step is meant to remove paint, and you'll see what I mean by that in a second. So I want to get some big chunky areas on here. Let's set the stencil like this. And now I'm going to bring in the Punchinello Trio. And now this one I'm actually going to move because I need to move this center section of dots around so I can pick up. Again, just some paper towel. I'm pressing straight down. My goal is to remove the paint through the openings in the Punchinello Trio stencil. All right, so that looks good. Let's see what I've got. I've got some right here that I can move, or remove rather. Got some here. All right. Let's see what we've got. So now I need to catch what's in here. Oops, that's hearts, not dots. All right. I want to be sure I get it out from the openings of the rays of the sunflowers too, so I'm kind of paying careful attention to where I'm dabbing and removing here. All right, so the last section is just up here. And one spot left. We should be good to go. All right, so now what I'm going to do is lift this, and you can already see what's starting to happen here. Grab a piece of Tyvek, come straight down, and go ahead and print this. And here we go. And how cool is that? You can see the Punchinella Trio patterned of those dots in the centers of the sunflowers and in the rays. You can see here where I missed. Oops, that's not good for me. But nevertheless, you get the point. Now, you're not limited. So long as you choose, not limited to those that combination of stencils, so long as you choose large openings with smaller, denser design for the inner pieces, it'll work. This is the same, this is the same sunflower stencil. This time I used our Wander stencil in there. This is the same sunflower stencil with the same colors, and this time I used the animal print croc and zebra, and I used the croc to lift the colors. This is our lotus flower stencil, and this was done also with the Punchinella Trio, the one that I just used, and here's the lotus flower done with the croc from the croc and zebra pattern. So you know, this is a really interesting technique that allows you to create all kinds of really fun patterning. The last thing I want to show you today combines a couple of things. Color mixing, because some of these dilutions colors, when you put them together, make a really great third color. And then the difference between what happens, and I'm talking about now a full-size stencil, when you use a stencil versus a mask, and that'll make a little bit more sense in a second. So let's bring out a couple of things. This is what happens when you print a mask. This is what happens when you ink the plate, lay the mask down, and pull a print. The background, the negative space, is what actually is colored, because the mask, in this case, this is our floral fantasy mask, the mask is protecting the other areas from becoming colored. And this is what happens when you print what's left on the plate once you remove the mask. On the other hand, this is what happens when you print a stencil. Again, you put color down, you lay the stencil, you print through the openings of the stencil. The positive areas are colored in the background, the negative area remains white. And this is what happens when you remove the stencil and print what's left. So you can see that there's a fairly similar appearance here, whereas the first steps are really quite different. So let's just do a little bit of this. So I'm going to use some Cherry Pie, and I'm going to use Calypso Teal, and they make the most luscious purple. It really is a beautiful color. So let's put some of the Calypso in there. And when I roll this with my brayer, when I spread this paint out into a nice thin layer, I'm actually going to roll it in lots of directions, and I'm less concerned, and I've got too much paint on here, I'm less concerned about maintaining the patterning, and sometimes that is my goal. Again, a little bit too much paint, so I'm gonna roll some of that off. I'm less concerned about maintaining the patterning as I am about letting the colors mix a little bit, and you can see that I'm getting this really interesting violet color. Alright, so let's just grab another piece of deli paper here and roll off my brayer so it's reasonably clean. Alright, so let's start with the Floral Fantasy mask. I'm going to pick a little bit of a different spot. I'm going to lay it down. Helps if my hands are clean. And I'm going to print it. So again, I'm just eyeballing this so that I'm not going to do anything with these, but it's just gotten to be force of habit at this point to kind of eyeball this with a piece of paper that's glued, or rather taped, to my table. So when I print the mask, this is what I get. And how pretty is that purple that gets made from the Cherry Pie and the Calypso Teal? So here's my mask. Now I'm going to remove the mask from the surface of the plate, and I'm going to print what remains. And this is what I get. So here are the two options. Now I'm going to go back to Calypso Teal, but I'm going to bring in some of the Dirty Martini just for a different colorway, so that we're not looking at the same thing over and over again. And you know what? That's probably going to be too much paint again, so we'll just wing it and see what happens. I'm all about winging it. All right, let's go ahead and use the brayer. Way too much paint. That was very over-enthusiastic application of the paint there. Alright, so obviously I'm not going to, because these colors are near to one another on the color wheel, I'm not necessarily going to get a third color out of it, in as much as I'm not going to see purple being made from red and blue. Oh my goodness, let me just roll this off over here. But I am going to see, obviously, a combination of the two. Alright, so in comes, this is our flower patch stencil. I'm very fond of this. This is one of Margaret Applin's designs. I'm going to lay that on there. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to put it down, and I'm going to print through the openings of the stencil. Now you can see here that, again, my look is very different because here I have the negative and here I have the positive. All right, so let's remove the stencil, put it to one side, grab what is almost my last piece of pre-cut paper, and now I'm going to print what remains on the plate. You know, these gel plates are an amazing tool that you can do so many really interesting things with. Whether you... Now, see, here I've picked up some of the mess that's left on the plate, and how interesting is that? Whether you create a print that is your end product, it's what it's meant to be, or you create interim things. You print on a journal page, or you print whatever it is that you're doing. It's a really wonderful tool that you can do many fun things with.